the capacity of a tumor to kill will actually depend on the tumor destroying the neighboring tissue. So basically you die because a tumor that arrives to an organ that's important for living gets destroyed by the presence of the tumor. And we think one of the ways of doing this is, for example, by abusing this mechanism of cell selection, where you have the tumor now becoming super fit and killing the neighboring cells, and therefore destroying the organ. We identified this fitness comparison mechanism in 2010, and these are marks that the neighboring cells use to know if the cell is young and healthy or is aged and damaged. And the interesting thing is that having the good or the bad mark is not per se deciding with whether the cell is going to die or not, because if the whole tissue is old, then that's what you have. You cannot have better cells, probably you will keep them. But if you have a very healthy young tissue and you start to have oldish or a little bit damaged cells, then these cells will be eliminated. So it's a relative quality control mechanism. Normally this system is beneficial for the organism to prevent aging and to prevent developmental malformations. In the case of cancers, it's detrimental for the organism because the tumors behave as super fit cells and they are able to convince the neighboring cells that they are the ones that should be eliminated, and by disrupting this normal mechanism of cell selection, they basically gain a competitive advantage and destroy the tissue. In this new study, Rajan Gonya and Esha at Madan decided to test whether these molecules that were identified in the fly, in Drosophila, are conserved in human cells. So basically we took human samples, including human cancer samples, and they analyzed how they select each other, and they showed that these molecules, these fitness fingerprints, are very important for cell selection. They also found that they are very important for tumor growth. So tumors have a version of the molecule that's, that makes the cells very fit and allows them to gain a competitive advantage by killing the neighboring tissue and destroying the tissue. The environment here is fantastic for this type of research because we can have access to patient samples and test hypotheses fast. And also, if we now want to do therapies, potentially there is also a lot of synergy.
We have provided this study samples of breast cancer, colon cancer, and prostate, and some others, common cancers. And what we have provided is the support to develop in these samples the same technology done in animal models to demonstrate the possibility in future time of testing these antibodies, these markers that in many ways is what they are developing to test, as I said, these in the human and make progress for the future treatment of these patients.
In principle, one could now block this pathway in patients with cancer, and then the tumors should become less aggressive, and we have evidence that this may be the case. So we could target drugs to block this fitness comparison, and now the tumors will not be able to destroy the neighboring tissue, and therefore the patients will probably be able to survive for longer. This will not eliminate the tumor itself. But what's interesting is that we also, Rajan has also obtained data that we can combine this with more classical treatments like chemotherapy. And then if you combine the inhibition of this cell fitness comparison pathway with chemotherapy treatments, then tumors disappear faster than if you only treat them with chemotherapy. Although, of course, we have to be aware that this is very preliminary and it will be many years until we can get to treat real patients.